Hi Geminis, welcome to my channel. So today we are going to do your mid-September reading and we'll see what are the tarot messages for you in the middle of the month, okay? And for those who are new to my channel, a warm welcome to you all. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing and hit the bell notification icon as well so that you will be able to get updated about my latest videos. Okay, so as you all know, this is a general reading. It might or might not resonate with all of you, all right? So let's see what is there for my Geminis in the middle of the month, in the mid-September for my Geminis. Angel spirits, guides, please help me find some answers for my Geminis. Okay. So. So let's see what is the overall situation right now. Is the Queen of Rods. Okay, so Taurus also got this as the Queen of Rods in the present situation. What is the conflict? The conflict is a judgment. So this is a reason over here that you might be in a situation where you have to take some decisions. Decisions regarding your career, decisions regarding your life, love life, anything it can be. It is up to your situation, whatever situation in which you are in. Okay, so this is more about, you know, when your inner callings are telling you that, you know, when angels are actually telling you that it is time for to take a decision in your life, whether it is good or bad, but it's time for a decision. So you cannot just, if you have some kind of a pending work or some kind of a pending decision, just go on with it, because with the Queen of Rods, she is like, she's a decision maker, and whatever decision she takes, it is actually a very valuable thing. Okay, so wherever you are, in whichever situation you are, just go with a yes or a no. With whatever situation you are, just go and take that decision. Okay, so what's in your subconscious? Your subconscious is Three of Wands. So this might be a wait for some kind of a progress. So this might be a wait for a promotion, a wait for a job interview, a call from a job or whatever. So this is a subconscious thing which is actually going on in your mind, and you are really, it's like somewhere in the subconscious that you know, but still you are, you know, when we don't want to look at stuff. So this might be a growth as well in your life where you do not looking towards. So that is why you are really going through that kind of a stage, that kind of a place where things are seeming that things are not quite good, but still you are waiting for something else. You know, waiting for the happiness to come towards you on its own, and that will not happen. It's always you who has to decide. Things will not happen by themselves. Efforts are from your side always, okay? Let's see what is the past situation. Knight of Swords. So you might have fought for some kind of a thing in your life. This is a more of a very rigid thing where you wanted something, a very, you know, rishi-rashi kind of a thing where you are like very fast, something related to your work. I'm seeing that regarding your work life, it came really fast towards you, but when it actually came, it was like, no, I never wanted this. You know, you are ignoring your growth when it came towards you. Well, we'll see what it is. What's in your mind right now? It's the Fool. So this Fool is basically, you know, you are all into that energy where you want to start with new beginnings, enthusiasm, new life, and taking things in a very enthusiastic way. Okay, proceeding towards your goal in a very new way, new something. Okay, so that is why you are not looking towards where you have already put your efforts in. You are moving on with something else. I got it. Okay, so here's the situation. You have already put your efforts in something else, might be in your past, but because of your impatience, you never waited for that thing long term, you know. It's like the progress is still going on and you're waiting, but the wait, you don't want to wait for it any longer. So you are trying to go towards something new. So let's start something new again. So you are in that stage where one thing has not been finished yet, but still you want to start something new. So that is why this judgment card is here, when you have to at least complete a process first, then you have to move on. So if this is kind of a situation in your life right now, so you just have to take some time. Okay, so be patient a little. Let the fruits grow, because fruits, they take time to grow. So let them grow, and whatever the results which you really need to get, they will come towards you. But you have to wait for everything. Okay, let's see in your future, the Two of Pentacles. See these two things in which you are dealing with, because your mind is actually somewhere else and your body, your spirit is telling you something else. So this is that kind of a place in your future which might arise, because you are already dealing with two things which one has not been finished yet, and you are going to start something new. Then what will happen? You will just try to settle, you know, sometimes here, sometimes there. You are just going to paddle it with, you know, it's your life and you are just paddling with it. But this is how, sometimes here it will be heaviness, sometimes here. So what will you try to do? You will try to balance, and you won't be able to balance that kind of an energy. So the advice over here is the judgment, that let the process complete first and then go towards the other thing. Okay, how you see yourself as the Six of Pentacles? Yeah, you really want to go on, because so these things might involve money with it. So that is why wherever more money is there, you are getting attracted towards that thing more. So not your problem, it's a general mindset. How people see you as a High Priestess? So this is the environment around you. The environment around you, see, the truth is there. Whatever you really need to hear from the universe, whatever you need to look at, things are there. Universe is telling you, universe is guiding you, the messages. It's you who has to hear. You know, you have to hear the answers, the hints, whatever you are getting. So if you are really taking, if you are really going to take that leap of faith, you know, that belief in yourself, sometimes you just enter in a thing without thinking. So if you haven't thought about it, start thinking. Because the High Priestess, she knows the reality. It's just, you know, you are trying to ignore with the fool over here. You know the reality. You know the answer. But it's like when we try to ignore the real answer. Okay, so lessons which you really need to learn with the Page of Wands over here. See, the Page of Wands is a very immature kind of an energy. So the lessons over here is like, see, whatever will happen in your life, whatever it is, you really have to deal with the things in a very mature way. Not just going towards something new and then leaving the past thing behind. No, life doesn't work like that. Okay, if you really, if you will, you will just keep something incomplete. If you left something, leave something incomplete in your life, things will really come back. Okay, so this is a cycle which you really need to complete. The karmic cycles which we always talk about, this is that thing. They really need to complete to start a new one. So that is why with the Page of Wands, you really need to, your energy is very high. It is actually shown over here. Yes, it is high, but it's up to you how to utilize your energy in a good way or a bad way. All right. What's the future energy? Temperance. Wow, the outcome energy over here, the Temperance is, you know, when you actually start gaining that balance, that harmony in you, because you are actually already trying to balance the energy, and the Temperance appears. In the future, you are trying to balance it, and the outcome is the Temperance. It's like when you try to balance two situations over here, and you achieve, you become successful balancing those two things. And you see over here, you are standing balancing the two cups of life, when you're trying to balance your what your body desires and what your mind desires. So that is what the outcome is over here. You are trying to do it and you are going to succeed in that thing. Okay, so we have over here, we have Aries, Leo and Sag. Yes, so it's more about your thing, whatever you really want in your life. It's all about how to get that thing, how to complete the past things and then to move on. So whatever things are pending in your life, complete those things first and then move on with the new things. All right, so that is all from my side, Gemini. I hope it helps, and we will meet you in the next video. Till then, bye.